they say they respect the money, pick the jewels.
I got you feeling that under.
106.7 Top of the Hill Radio, bringing you new trap hits. Tune into the Top of the Hill now to listen. Long Island's hottest trap radio.
I cannot fall off. Walking on a tightrope, but I stay fly.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to 106.7 Top of the Hill Radio. Today, I'm joined by my good friends, Alejandro and, of course, Mo. Coming in from his wonderful home today. So today we're going to talk about a lot of stuff, and thank you for listening and thank you for being here. So hey guys, what's going on? How you guys doing?
Pretty good, bro. I'm just ready to talk about this new rap scene going on. A lot of things happening lately, bro.
It's a wild scene, you know, and really quarantine really hasn't put a pause on it. Things are still, music is still pumping out, and it's really a lot of stuff has been better than ever, you know.
Yeah, honestly.
Yeah, so like, dude, first thing I want to talk about like Playboy Cardi, man.
That whole Playboy lot of Cardi. Red, man.
Dude, first thing that happened, people were hating on it. People were hating on an album as soon as it started.
Yeah, and not going to lie, though, I low-key was not messing with the album when it first dropped, just because, I don't know, there's a lot of aspects that first off the bat, like, don't sound good, you know what I mean? Like, his voice just sounds really strained on a few of the songs. Like, it just kind of sounds like the mixing is off. But then I had to listen to it a few times and see what he was really trying to do with it, you know?
Yeah. You know what? I got to say, like, first off, the production, like, the music behind it is solid. And that's something that's so consistent with Playboi Carti. He always has fantastic producers. And you know what? What happened with, like, if you look at Playboi Carti's discography, and how he began with self-titled,
yeah,
and then he released Die Lit, and now WLR, Whole Lot of Red. When his first album came out, I'm not sure how the reception was on that, because he wasn't really too popular that.
His first album was received pretty well, bro. It had Magnolia on it, and dude, that kind of just brought him up like a step higher, because he was like an underground trap sound. Like, he was along with, he wasn't from the same place, but he was along with the same wave, like, X and Lil Pump and Ski Mask and Smoke Perp. You know, he was kind of moving with that kind of wave with his own little flair to it, and I feel like self-titled really brought him more into the rap game and gave him more mainstream recognition.
Well, it definitely launched his career, because you know, he began just releasing like singles and stuff. He never had a body of work, like an album, before he had a self-titled,
right?
And you know what happened, which, well, I was continuing on from before, is when Die Lit was released, there was a lot of hating on that, as well, mm-hmm, as WLL War Hat.
Yeah.
And you know what? Everyone grew to love Die Lit. And I feel like, you know, what's going to happen is we just got to give WLL time.
Well, I already see some influence from Whole Lot of Red leaking into other rappers, because he really brought that kind of rock sound. Like, if you look at the frequencies that he uses on the songs, you could see the same frequencies that you can see in actual rock songs, and he brought that into the rap game. And you could see that DaBaby just dropped a new single, and that had like the guitar in it.
Right.
Juice WRLD, they dropped a song with him and Young Thug, and that had a real rock feeling, even though Juice WRLD was kind of on that before. But I feel like,
yeah,
they just timed that after Whole Lot of Red, because Playboi Carti brought that in. He introduced it.
Though, he really like influenced the rock sound in hip hop too.
Yeah, like, I feel like Uzi,
when he first came out with that.
Right.
But yeah.
I feel like Uzi really like started the idea of rappers becoming rock stars, but a lot of new rappers have taken that and like kind of gone with it in their own way.
Yeah, definitely. And he's like one of the most like I would say like the most iconic like new rappers of this age. Cause like what other like new age rapper has like a song with Pharrell? Not anybody really.
Yeah.
Like, he just keeps going up and going up, and like I don't see it ever stopping, you know?
Yeah.
I really like watching Playboi Carti evolve as an artist is fascinating. And what makes him like evolve so well is that he's not like fearful of putting his sound out there, like what he wants to make.
Right.
And like a common theme on WLR was like the distortion kind of sounds and like heavy like bass mm-hmm. and a lot of drive and like the structure of his tracks. And it's sick.
I gotta say, so I really like to see, I can really appreciate new rappers that have their place in the rap game still bring that raw distorted sound into their music, because that's just kind of what I've been noticing, is that a lot of rappers that came up off that sound ended up just turning into just an overproduced like sound, you know, like Smoke Perp, Lil Pump. I mean, they're not really good rappers, but the reason that they were lit and their songs were fun is because they just had this raw like ignorant feeling, and they had distortion to their sound.
Yeah.
and they just ended up being overproduced. You hear their songs now and they just sound like mush, like they just don't really have any type of like eye-catching sound, you know?
You know what? And totally, like, honestly, you do not need like substance in matters of like lyricism to blow up,
right?
Like, yeah. Like Lil Pump, a great, bro.
Yeah, Lil Pump, Playboi Carti is a great example of that. He's not known for being a lyricist.
Right. Dude, but honestly, bro, on this new album, he just, like, okay. So it's not incredibly deep stuff that he's talking about, but also it's, like, really, like, it's, like, empowering ideologies, you know? It's all just sick, sick lyrics, man. Like a rock star would say.
Yeah.
And it's sick.
But I also... It's a time and a place, you know, because I also can appreciate a lot of different styles. Lil Baby has a very different style, but he's very consistent with his flows, and he can rap too. Still brings that trap sound to his music without making it sound forced.
Dude, Lil Baby's so talented, man.
Yeah.
So talented. And, you know, they're talking about like influence, how like Playboi Carti is influencing other artists. Lil Baby, I think you were telling me this, Alejandro. If you have a feature with Lil Baby, you're blowing up.
Right, bro. It's a clip. Like that song is gonna be a hit. Regardless, if you're a one hit wonder, that's up to you. You gotta take advantage. Like a lot of rappers, also like the Drake features. I thought Lil Baby was gonna be like that with the Drake feature. With Yes Indeed, I thought he was just going to be a one-hit wonder, but he really took that and ran with it, you know? He took that recognition that he got from that song and kind of used it to make himself better.
To launch his career, really.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah.
And also, he's just so consistent. Like, I don't think I've ever heard... Okay, so Lil Baby has better songs than his other songs, but I've never like listened to a Lil Baby song and be like, damn, this kind of sucks.
Yeah.
Like he's always just pumping out like, volume.
It's just consistency. And I really like how he tried to make his own sound, because other rappers that were brought up from that type, that rap scene from Young Thug, like Lil Keed, he's a good rapper, but he doesn't really have a very iconic sound, you know? He has like a kind of copy and paste sound, which
he
is
sounds like an off-brand version of like Playboi Carti, kind of. Like
yeah, almost. Playboi Carti or no Young cap. Thug, like it's just they kind of mix together, and sometimes it's good. But I mean, I like to hear like iconic sounds. Gunna has a good sound, you know what I mean? And what I can appreciate about Gunna and Lil Baby, you can compare them very closely because they're pretty similar with the way that they structure themselves, and they like Gunna has his own flow that matches his voice, and Lil Baby has his own flow that matches his voice, and they both work very well by themselves and together.
Totally. And you know what, like, dude, another influential person in like rap music today is Kanye West. Oh, and there's just definitely. Dude, this man ran for president. He so many artists like kind of grew off of him. He's such an influential figure and an icon, and it's always cool to hear about his stuff. But yeah, it's sick.
Yeah.
But yeah, you know what? We're just about to wrap this up, so you know I feel like we covered some cool topics today, and you're gonna hear a little baby song soon to be played on our radio station 106.7 Top of the Hill Radio, featuring our good friends Alejandro and Mo. And you know what? I feel like it's been great conversation today. And
great talking to you guys, man.
Definitely.
All right. Top of the Hill
Radio. What do you want to be when you grow up? This basic question is asked by almost everyone. And well, it can be hard to know what track you want to go on. So Wilson Tech helps out with that. Wilson Tech is a school that helps both students and adults develop skills for the area of work they choose. There are multiple programs you can choose from to get a look at a career you like or you may choose in the future. Wilson Tech has a handful of programs that take a look at careers like service careers, technical careers, transportation careers, construction careers, graphics and media careers, and health careers. For more information, visit wilsontech.org. Plan ahead, think of your future.
Spice up your living room or add a little color to the kids' room? Head to Sherwin-Williams where you can find gorgeous paint colors and wallpapers. Bring color to life with Sherwin-Williams. For more information, visit sherwinwilliams.com.
This is Andrew Hill reporting from 102.7 The Buck Wild on the topic of new album releases this December. On the 11th, Kid Cudi's Man on the Moon 3 was released, concluding the trilogy, featuring an 18-song track list, gaining entirely positive reviews, with possibly a collaboration album with him and Travis Scott in some point next year.
Also, the official release date of Playboi Carti's Whole Lotta Red has been finally announced. On Christmas Day, we will receive the long-awaited album, which was first spoken of in August of 2018. A sneak peek at one of the songs was posted on Playboi Carti's Instagram page, showing Kanye West involved in the production. Hopefully, we will get a feature from Kanye, and possibly an update on the release of his also many times delayed album. This has been Andrew Hill from 102.7 The Buckwild, reporting on new album releases in December of 2020.
Apple's new AirPods Max takes the consumer over-ear headphone listening experience to the next level. With custom drivers delivering high-fidelity playback with ultra-low distortion across the entire audible range. And a pair of Apple's H1 chips allow real-time, calculated features like adaptive EQ, which tailors the sound to your unique fit by measuring and adjusting what you're hearing up to 200 times per second. With their noise-canceling technology with 8 microphones, they listen to the sound around you to block them out and give you a personalized experience. Also including spatial sound, Apple's new AirPods Max offer the latest cutting-edge technology on the market. So for more information or to purchase, go to apple.com.
106.7,
Top of the Hill.
Apple's AirPods Max offer you the latest cutting-edge technology of high-fidelity audio. With Apple's H1 chip, you can tap into 10 audio cores to give you the best personal listening experience possible. So for more information or to purchase, go to apple.com.
Top of the Hill Radio.
All right. Travis Scott, man. He just does a lot. He has his grips on the rap game right now, bro.
Yeah, you think so?
Yeah, he's up there, bro, especially now. Yeah, bro.
Astroworld, you know, that album really put him on. Like, he really came up on that one. And not even Astroworld, like his past songs, like Babes in the Trap, you know what I mean?
I think what really solidified his place in the rap game was Rodeo. Arguably greatest trap album of all time. But people compare it to, like, a lot of other things. What do you think, bro?
I feel like I could compare compare him to like Future in a way, because Future uses like mad autotune, bro. And Travis Scott uses mad autotune too.
Yeah, Future's more like raw with it though.
Yeah, he is more raw with it. Unlike Travis, like he uses his ad libs and like the way he just does his vocals. He uses just like. He it's like an instrument, right? It's like an instrument. So
I feel like Rodeo is more like masterful though, like the transitions he used, the features, and the way he structures all the songs, like almost like orchestral pieces.
Right.
Like people call them like Trap Mozart, like all that, bro.
Trap Mozart.
but you could see that type of layout with albums and songs. Other genres of rap too, like Tyler Creator with Igor, it's easy to compare that one because they both had Playboi Carti a collaboration with him in one way or another. With he had Earthquake with Playboi Carti where he used his feature as part of the song instead of just a feature, you know what I mean? Because he had a lot of other artists collaborating on that song,
right.
And Travis Scott. He was seen featured in Love Hurts on Playboi Carti's album where he added that. It was more of a feature because it was Travis Scott as a feature, but he added that like tasteful, masterful like side of the song to like kind of bring it together. You know what I mean? Because Love Hurts wouldn't be the same song without
him. Right. Yeah, exactly. Like his parts and like how he just masters his vocals and like how he just like does... uses his vote, like his literal voice as an instrument to make things better, you know, like he uses it as like a way to almost like manipulate the track into it sounding
the way he uses like, auto-tune, like different from other rappers that use auto-tune. He uses it more of an instrument and incorporates it into the beats. Like he has a big role in all the production of his songs. Like, he's either producing or he's mixing. He's always listed as one of the main writers for his songs.
Right.
Yeah.
But you could see like the influence from Kid Cudi. I mean, his name, part of his name came from Kid Cudi, because Kid Cudi's actual name is Scott Mezcudi. And you could see like a lot of the similarities, like you, like the way that Cudi uses hums in a lot of his songs, especially his older albums. Travis Scott, like you could see that a lot of that kind of overlap with Travis Scott's style, but Travis Scott brings it more into like a mainstream trap, especially nowadays that it's like one of the most popular genres of music.
Right. Yeah. But like I feel like I don't really listen to Travis as much as you do, clearly. I don't listen to Travis that much, but what I have listened to, like for example, Babes in the Trap, Astroworld, and all that, he uses his ad libs, you know, like where he goes like key or whatever.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, exactly. Like, all right, you know, like he uses his ad libs and manipulates them to make them sound like they're supposed to be like
that's like where it's supposed to be. Like you hear exactly. That, all right, you hear him say yeah, like that's exactly. Where it's supposed to come in. Like it, there's no other way, you know what I mean? It would sound right. Better without it.
Exactly.
Yeah, I feel that's like a lot bad. Of those elements of his music can also be attributed to Kanye West, who kind of solidified the use of autotune and ad libs like that in trap, especially in 808s and Heartbreak, where he was really poetic with how he wrote the songs and portrayed his emotions throughout the album, mainly using autotune in most of the songs.
Right, exactly. And like for example, in Father's Hands, Kanye used his autotune.
Yeah, and he had he had that kind of future sound, but he
exactly.
Kanye has a really good way of like making it poetic while right. He's talking, and it's like you can listen to it just to like vibe out, or you can exactly. Listen to it and see the metaphors that he's referencing. You know what I mean?
Yeah, he definitely has like a good use of words. Like he definitely like sits down and takes his time with his lyrics. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I feel like Travis Scott has a big role in like the evolution of the trap sound. You know what I mean? He went from Days Before Rodeo, which was a really like raw sounding mixtape. Then he went to Rodeo, which kind of solidified what trap was that we know today. Then he went to Birds in the Trap, where he kind of brought more of like a fun like rager sound to it. And then he went to Astroworld, which brought like mainstream appeal. He had Drake right. On it. He had all these features that are more new, like more new sounding, like Juice WRLD, you know.
Yeah.
And he just brought all that together, like Nav. You know what I mean? Nav
exactly.
Nav in the end of
yeah, he definitely changed up trap, because with trap before, it used to be just raw,
like raw it vocals. Used to be just trap, like actual trap music,
exactly, like just
only
raw
drugs
vocals.
No, there's no story, like nothing
exactly.
Like that,
but he like kind trap, of like basically it was trap, like you
yeah
know?
But now trap is a different, like it actually means like a different genre, you know what I mean?
Exactly. Now it's more poetic. Now you can talk about yeah. Anything other than drugs. And
don't get me wrong, like there's nothing wrong with just like a song that you're not really saying anything, just to like it's yeah. A bop, you know what I mean? But I really appreciate artists saying something else, especially like people that came up off of that Travis Scott wave, like Don Toliver. He basically molded him. He molded Don Toliver.
Yeah, exactly.
Because Don Toliver before he was part of that Travis Scott thing, especially before Astroworld, where like he was. That's when I first heard of him on Can't Say. He sounds almost exactly like him, but with more like a singy. Like he sings more.
Right. Okay. Yeah.
But like, there's some songs by Don Toliver that were written by Travis Scott. And like you can really see like the influence, like he's basically his son.
That's his son. That's Travis Scott Jr. right there.
Yeah, I could see Travis Scott like growing more and having more of like a fatherly figure to other rappers, like how Young Thug has to, like, you know, Gunna, Lil Baby, Lil Key. Young Thug brings up a lot of rappers like that, and I could see Travis Scott like bringing up a lot of rappers, but to of a thing.
Lil Baby is different though. Like, he just goes out raw. Like,
Lil Baby's more consistent with it. He's more raw, and
he's very poetic. And I feel like he just goes off on every beat that you just give him. Like, it doesn't matter what it is, doesn't matter how it sounds. Like, he can go hard on it.
Yeah. You know? Yeah. With him, the fact that his style hasn't really changed since he came up. Is a good thing. Like, with other rappers, that wouldn't really be a good thing. The only thing that you could say that has mainly changed about Lil Baby's whole, like, his songs and his work has been the quality of audio, because obviously the bigger you get, the more you have access to, the more the better studios, microphones, all that quality,
right?
And you could just hear that. But he has the same style, and that has really kept him going because of the consistency of his songs.
Right, exactly. And I don't know if you heard like his past songs or anything, but like you said, like his past songs, like the audio, like, and his audio from then and his audio now is a major, major difference.
Yeah. You know? Not and gonna like you lie, said, though, because I thought he was going to be like a, like, almost for a second, it looked like he was just going to be a one hit wonder, though, because of the S&D, like, there's a lot of rappers that have the Drake feature and they go big, but then they never come back from that. You know what I mean? Because a Drake feature nowadays in rap is just like a high point for a lot of people, or it brings them back. Like Meek Mill, like, he basically just like gives Meek Mill his career now. Like, every time he gives him a feature, you know what I mean?
Exactly. All right, bro. Well, I appreciate you having me out here. You know. You know, thank you for giving me the opportunity, you know, to talking segment with in the radio. And I appreciate you for having me.
Yeah. All right.
Top of the Hill Radio.
Thanks for joining us at the Top of the Hill Radio. We hope you enjoyed the show with us and you tune in once again. 106.7. Top of the Hill Radio, Long Island's hottest trap radio.
Hold up, who are you? Oh, you ain't never made the news. Drummer get reloaded, you don't wanna make the news. My manager say they respect the money, peak the jewels.